Dropshippers often debate between using WordPress or Shopify for their online store. But if you want to create a long-term brand, I would suggest you to opt for WordPress WooCommerce. Here are a few reasons why choose WordPress WooCommerce.
So WordPress is cost-effective. With no monthly fees, you just need and hosting plan which you can get from Hostinger. So Hostinger is a popular web hosting platform that offers reliable, secure and affordable hosting solutions. That too with excellent customer services. So itni sari tarif ke baad, let's show you how to customize an e-commerce store on WordPress WooCommerce. So let's start customizing our store. So to customize our store, we need a hosting plan. You might be wondering why it is important to take a hosting plan and domain for your website. Hosting plan is very important because you need a space on internet where you can showcase your website and the products, and all the products that you're going to add, it is going to take more and more space on the internet. So for that, you need a web hosting where you can represent your website online on internet, and you need a good one so that you can add more and more products because you are occupying some space on the internet to showcase your website. I hope you get that. So to start with that, we are going to purchase a web hosting for our website that we are going to create on WooCommerce WordPress. So for that, I'm going to search for Hostinger. So you can see this is Hostinger's official page, and you might have seen a lot of videos in our channel. We mostly purchase domains and web hosting from Hostinger only because they are pretty trustworthy, and I really like the interface and everything. It's very easy. It makes your job pretty easy and you don't have to hassle around for web hosting and domain. So if you are ever going to buy any domain or a web hosting plan, go choose Hostinger. So for that, you can see we have this option WordPress hosting, and you can see that they have an exciting offer going on that is up to 82% off on hosting and website building, and plus you will be getting a free domain and free website migration. They also provide free website migration. Website migration means if you already have a website that is and some other hosting platform, you can migrate it in here with Hostinger, so it's pretty free. You don't have to pay any charge for that, and plus 24/7 customer service, and their customer service is bomb. So they have 149 rupees per month starting plan, you can see. So let's start. So first of all, I'll be going with the WordPress one. So I'm going to purchase WordPress hosting, premium WordPress hosting. They have a lot of plans, you can see. So this is their premium plan. In premium plan, we are getting 100 websites plus 25,000 monthly visits and 100 GB SSD storage and 4 lakh files and everything. But the most important thing that matters is how many website visit you can get, because if you are going to scale your website and customers are going to come in your website, and if they can't open your website page or it's very slow, so it is going to low down the conversion and you will end up making losses if you're running ads for your store. So I would suggest if you're going to scale your products in the future, so your website has a premium plan so that it doesn't crash if there are many customers trying to buy some same product or some sale is going on. So always purchase a good premium hosting. So you have already seen the plan. This is single plan, premium, business and cloud startup. I think premium will be a decent one, so I'll be going with that. Choose a plan. So here you have to select a period, like how many months you want your web hosting. So I think 12 months is pretty decent. I'll go with 12 month. They also have the option of 1 month also. For 1 month, it will be around like 599. So let's select the 12 month plan. So my subtotal is around like 2628. Now they are asking, do you have any coupon code? So yes, I do have a coupon code. I have to put Digital Heroes. You can see I have got an instant discount of 10%. If you also want a discount, you can just use our coupon code and you will be getting an instant discount. So we have affiliate link, you can choose that and you will be getting an instant discount. You can use our coupon code whenever you are buying a domain or web hosting from Hostinger. So without any bird, let's get started. So it is asking for my email, so I'm going to log in with my email. So now we are on the billing address page. I'm just going to fill it all quickly. So you can see I have gotten request from Hostinger for a auto pay mandate. It's basically nothing like you can see that I was about to pay for around like 2,600 or 2,700, but now the auto mandate request that has come to my phone pay, that is around like 5,300. It's double what we are about to pay. It's just an auto mandate request, like once your plan will be over, after it is going to auto debit your plan again if you are not going to remove your auto pay. So make sure once you will buy the hosting plan, remove the auto pay from your UPI. So it is just asking for setting up the auto pay. You don't have to be scared, they are not going to deduct the money. So once my auto pay has been set up, so now it is asking for who is this website for? Is it for myself, for my business, or for someone else? So it's for myself, obviously. So it's been a long time since I was thinking of creating a WordPress website on WooCommerce. So it's been a pretty long time since I've been thinking of creating a WordPress website. It's a one-time payment thing. You don't have to pay on monthly basis because Shopify fees are pretty high. If you're using multiple apps, then you have to pay for those apps also. So that is why I was thinking of creating an organic brand on WooCommerce. So finally the time has come. So it's asking, do you want to create or migrate a website? Migrating website is basically if you already have an existing website, you can migrate your website in this particular platform, that is Hostinger. Otherwise it's up to you. If you want to create a new one, obviously I'm going to create a new one because I don't have an existing website. I'll create a new one, select next, create login details for a WordPress account. So most of the things are here. I just have to write my password. So once doing that, let's select what type of website do you want to build. So you want to build an online website, blog, portfolio. So I'm going to select for online store because I'm going to create an online store that I have already told you. So they have this very interesting thing that mostly you can't see on other hosting websites. So you can see they have a pre-built website. Like you have to select, there are multiple themes given over here. You just have to select which one you would like to go for. It depends on you whether you would like to go for a pre-built theme. If something is matching with your ideology, like your vision, what kind of store you were trying to make, theme matches, you can just go with the pre-built website. Otherwise, if you want to do everything on your own, you can just skip this part. The pre-website are pretty good, like they are pretty aesthetic. So I would like love to go with pre-built website. I think I'll be selecting this one. They also have a preview option. So now that we have done with our payment gateway, you just have to go to the home page and just go to login, and the email that you have used, go select that. Once doing that, you can see so they have this very interesting feature that I haven't seen in many websites. I don't want to take the name, but this particular feature is just wow, like it has all my heart, because you can see they have this pre-built website feature that allows you to select a website that is already pre-designed. You just don't have to do each and everything on your own. Like all the thing, if you want to customize a website on your own, like you want to do every single thing on your own, it's up to you. You can skip this part. So let's have a look how our WordPress WooCommerce website look like. So I'll be going to the wizard site. So this is how my website looks like. It's a template. And if I'll go back and I'll go to wizard store, it is going to take me to the collection page where all the collection and shop by category and everything will be mentioned over here. So now it's time for me to change the logo and everything. You can see the CK thing is the basic one that came along with the template. So firstly, I would like to customize few more things. So you can see we have tons of options over here. The active theme is Astra. So I'll begin with changing the logo. So I already made one logo from Canva, and I'm going to use the same logo that I made in this particular website, and the name is Urban Threads Co. And it's made in India. Once doing that, logo with select the size of the logo, what size you actually want, and then you can also check the site visibility according to whether your audience will be on phone, laptop, iPod, how your website will actually look on all these platforms. You can check accordingly with the site title visibility. So now I'm going to add the site title, that is Urban Threads Co. and I'm going to publish it. So I can see that it's not changed yet. Let's check it once more time. We'll go to customize again, and we'll go to WooCommerce section, general. So WooCommerce sidebar, widget, menu. So now that our logo part is already done, now it's time for me to set up main menus and the footer menu. So we'll go to appearance, then menus, and you can see we have tons of option over here, like add menu items, menu structure. So we'll begin with the main menu. We also call it primary menu. So you can see we have these sections that are already in the main menu, but you can change accordingly what you want to add. So first of all, main menu should be consisting of, so first of all, I'm going to show you how it actually looks like. Like, it has shop by category, new arrivals, and that's all. So I'm going to add the home page, about, contact, and I'm going to save these menu items. After saving, you can see reloading this, all the things that I've selected is going to be visible over, like home, about, contact. I don't think contact is mandatory, so let's go and change more things. So we'll remove the contact page over here because I want contact to be in the footer menu. Once doing that, let's save this. So you can see after reloading this, this contact page is not visible, and this is how the footer menu looks like. It's basic. So I'm going to add some more things in the footer menu. So we'll select the footer menu, and now footer menu mainly consists of privacy policy, refund policy. But now you can see that privacy policy is not here. My story, awards and achievement, this is not mandatory, so I'm removing that. Once removing that, I need to add these pages, but it is not available in the add menu items. We have cart, checkout, collection. So now let's for privacy policy, let's see whether they have one or not. I don't think they have the section of policies, so we need to go to the pages and add all these pages, only then it will be going to be available in the add menu items. Let's go to pages, and you can see I can see some policies like refund policy and privacy policy. So I'm going to select these. This is how it looks like. You can add your brand name and then publish. Once publishing it, it will be going to be added in the add menu item. So from there we can add it directly to our footer menu. This is how our privacy policy page looks like. I'm going to publish this one also. I'm selecting more things like cart. You can arrange the structure of your menu. So I'm arranging the structure of my footer menu. Cart, privacy policy, checkout. So this is going to be the series, like serial wise arranging that. Now once it is done, I'm going to save this. I want collection tab to be available also, and the new arrivals also. So once reloading this, you can see all these things will be available in my footer menu, like privacy policy, cart, checkout, about me, and everything. I can still see that my logo is not visible in the footer menu. I need to change that also. So I will be going to the appearance section in the footer builder widget one. Let's see whether I have the option of changing my logo in the footer menu, because I can see CK. So in the main menu, logo is already changed, but not in the footer menu. So we need to do that manually. Let's go to footer builder. Changing this, we need to welcome to block widget. So guys, you have to explore a lot. Like, everything is already given like Shopify, but you need to explore. It's not like you are tapping here and here and I'm going to guide you all through, but everything is available here on WooCommerce. There's nothing that you need to code or something. Everything is very basic and not so very complicated. You can do that easily. What you want, like if you want to change something in the footer menu, everything is available. So I'm writing something more about my brand. So you can type about your brand, what your brand actually represents. So I'm writing like 2 to 3 lines just for the reference, how you can do that. And you can also select the alignment and the heading design, like how much the size of the heading you want to be visible. And now I'm selecting my logo, brand logo. It's coming down there. So let's see whether it will be available in the HTML1 or HTML2. So here is the option of adding media. So I'm selecting my logo, and but the quote written over here, you can adjust that. And once doing that, I think we are ready to go and we are going to publish it. So once publishing it, let's see how it actually looks in the footer section. So the logo section is already done. Now I want to change the image banner that says party wears. Just don't find the photo very interesting, so I want to change something so that more of the audience can connect to that. So let's see how we can change that photo that is already over there, that comes along with the template. Now I'm going to change it from the photos that are already available, or else we can download and then upload it. So the content in the text editor, you can see it's already written all the things like party wear collection, new dresses and everything. If you want to edit any of it, you can do that. You just have to edit it and then you have to publish it. That's all, not so complicated. And the codes and everything that you are seeing, you can avoid doing that. So now I'm going to change the main menu photo. So we are still trying to change the image banner photo that was already there. So we'll go to the home section and see what we can do. Like we have multiple section, column, style, advanced. So here I'm selecting the image from the files, and this photo I have chosen, and you can also select background and everything, which background goes with the theme of your website. You can also select the size of the which section you want to be more visible. So I'm selecting this top so that this girl along with her dress, it's pretty visible, so that you can decide the maximum height and everything. It's almost like Shopify. So once doing that, you can see the image that we have selected, it's visible. And if you want to change this party wears and everything, you can do that also. So now I'm going to show you the WooCommerce plugin. I'm going to show you how you can add new products in the WordPress. So we'll go to the product section over here, and here you can see all the options of all product, new product, categories, tags, attribute, reviews. So we'll go to add new, and we are going to add the product name. For adding the product name, I have chosen to copy Amazon product, so I'm going to copy the name and going to paste it over here. Once doing that, we have to add the product description as well, so I'm going to add the product description from their page. Now I'm pasting it. Now I'm going to show you how you can add the product image as well. So you can see the option over here to set the product image. Just select that, and the dress image, I have already saved it, so I'm just going to select that. And you can add the product image from the gallery as well. Once doing that, you just have to publish it, and it is going to be visible. To check that, let's see whether this product is actually visible or not. So we'll go to the view section to view this product, and you can see this product is viewing over here, and the description is in the below section. So now you can see the category is uncategorized, so we need to add the category also. So we'll go to the edit section again, go to edit, and now I'm going to add the product category. This particular product comes in the dress category, so we are going to do that and update it. You can see the category of the product is upgraded. It is coming in the dress section. Now I'm going to show you how you can add the sizes in the product. Like you can see, sizes are missing. We don't have the option of adding the sizes. So now I'm going to show you how you can add the sizes. So we'll go to product section, all products. So I'm going to select one product that I'm going to show you how we can add the sizes. So you can see in this product, we don't have any size chart available. So we'll go to edit section, and here we'll go to attributes, and here I'm going to add the size and adding the attributes. So I'll just keep on adding the sizes, like S for small, add new size, M for medium, and L, XL and double XL I'm going to add till then. So once doing that, let's go to all product section, go to edit section, and here you can write the regular price and the sale price as well, and I'm going to add the sizes. Go to size section and select all and save the attributes. Once saving it, let's see whether it's visible or not. It's still not visible, so we need to do more thing. Let's go back. So now we are going to select the product data. Always select variable product if you want to add some sizes or colors. So once selecting the variable product, you can see we have got a lot of options. So one thing main that you need to add is that you need to add the regular price. It is required. Only then you can move forward and the sizes will be available. So once adding the regular price, and it will ask you to add the prices in each of the section. Like if you are going with the medium large, you need to add the prices again and again, so that because most of the time sizes and the prices of the product varies on the sizes. The larger the size, the more money the customer have to pay. So that is why it is asking you to add the price again and again size wise. So once doing that, you can see our sizes are available. If you want to arrange this, I haven't arranged it, that is why it is looking like this. If you want to arrange that, you can do that too. You can see all the sizes are available, you can add to cart. Now once doing that, you just have to save it. So this is how you customize your WordPress WooCommerce website on WooCommerce using Hostinger. The interface is really simple. It might look from the other side that a lot of things like coding and everything is there, but all the things are given. You just have to go and explore. So the interface of WordPress WooCommerce is pretty much easy. Like any of the beginner who doesn't know coding can do that. A little bit of things you might seek help, you can do from YouTube, but the basic how you can customize your website on WooCommerce, I've already showed you. Like the basic thing, image, banner, changing your logos, how you can put on your product. So the products that I've showed you, these were already came along with the template. But if I want to remove and add more products of my own, I can just go simply and add my product as I've shown you. So this is how much easy it is. I
I don't have to pay any monthly subscription. So this is how you easily customize your WordPress WooCommerce website using Hostinger. You just need to try it and it's very simple. And if you're looking to purchase a web hosting, do it from Hostinger. It's a very trustworthy platform and you can get an instant discount of 10% off using our code, that is Digital Heroes. So yeah guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.